Okay, should we do another one?
Sure.
Okay, let's see if we can turn this on again.
Mr. Humphrey, my name's Nikki. I'm one of the nurses here in the emergency department. I need to ask you a few questions about what brought you here today.
Okay.
I understand you're having trouble passing your water.
That's right. I try and I try to pee, but I only dribble a little. I feel full, like I have to go and can't. Okay. My doctor told me to come in.
When was the last time you were able to pass your water normally?
About 10 a.m.
All right. Have you noticed any burning?
A little.
Any blood?
No.
All right. Had a fever, chills?
Nope.
All right. On a scale of 0 to 10, with 10 being the worst pain you can imagine, how would you rate this discomfort?
Maybe a 4.
Okay. Do you see a doctor regularly for anything? High blood pressure, heart disease, cancer, diabetes?
No, I'm as healthy as a horse.
All right. Do you take any medicines regularly?
Just an aspirin a day.
All right. Any allergies to anything?
No.
Okay, good.
As you look at this patient, it is clear he does not meet criteria for ESI level 1. He presents to the emergency department with the inability to urinate for about 4.5 hours, probably due to benign prostatic hypertrophy. He looks comfortable. He is able to sit in the chair and calmly give his history to the triage nurse, and he rates his level of discomfort as 4 over 10. So he does not meet the criteria for ESI level 2. If, while waiting, his discomfort increased significantly, he could always be up-triaged. Remember, the patient in severe distress due to urinary retention would be pacing, probably tachycardic, unable to sit still, and verbalizing to the triage nurse that he is miserable. If this patient looked miserable, he would have been assigned ESI level 2 due to distress. So let's move on to the next step in the algorithm. The triage nurse then answers the question, how many different resources will this patient consume? A patient with urinary retention will need a urethral catheter, a urinalysis, and perhaps a urine culture. Two resources, a procedure plus a lab. The patient's vital signs are within normal limits, so this patient is an ESI level 3.
So what do you think? Do you agree? Mm-hmm. ESI level 3?
Sure.
I thought it was very clear-cut. I mean, it's a very uncomplicated patient and pretty straightforward, not in a lot of distress.
Exactly. He was able to sit there. I think that should, particular segment showed that very well.
Right. But he'll need procedures and labs, so he'll take some time.
So the resource piece was clear.
Now, when you say labs, are you saying blood work too?
Well, certainly urinalysis, because he could have an infection too. Mm-hmm. Sometimes that's a urinary tract infection.
That's a good point, but remember, lab doesn't matter whether it's blood, urine, or stool.
Correct.
It's still one resource. So his resources were a urethral catheter and lab, too. He's an ESI level 3.